We've probably been living on a diet of gold medals and glory stories for the last couple of weeks. Yep. But while you're pretending to be Simone Biles in your living room, the real world has been carrying on. I did a full dismount on the couch. It was perfect. Yeah. Here's all the political drama that's been unfolding while you were away.
First up, the PM announced a major cabinet reshuffle.
A team that is united, a team that is ambitious, a team that is absolutely focused on continuing to deliver and work.
Claire O'Neill and Andrew Giles dumped from their scandal-plagued home affairs and immigration portfolios.
What you do when there's a reshuffle is that there is a change that then has a knock-on effect.
While former Workplace Relations Minister Tony Burke bagged both their old jobs.
He's certainly up for it.
Meanwhile, the CFMEU imploded amid explosive allegations of crime and corruption. Boss John Setka stepping down.
False allegations, the majority of them.
As the government fast-tracks new laws to force the union to appoint an independent administrator.
We cannot stand by and allow a once-proud union to be infiltrated by bikies and organised crime or have bullying and thuggery as part of its day-to-day business.
Don't f***ing lie. And you little f***ing jerk. You think I won't f*** you up too?
Pressure over the CFMEU scandal not letting up as the opposition calls for a Senate inquiry.
What we've seen is contractual arrangements between CFMEU-controlled companies and state government.
This is just a political stunt from the opposition.
Speaking of political stunts, in New South Wales, public sector workers have been ordered back into the office. Actually, that's real.
If you work 5 days a week, it'll be not less than three.
Businesses were pumped.
I've been dreaming of that. Please let them come back as soon as possible.
Beleaguered bureaucrats, less so.
We've adjusted our lives to accommodate the need to work at home. And then just to get news that the direction is to be back in the office is stressful.
And it wouldn't be a politics wrap without some nuclear-powered subs. The PM today shooting down rumours Australia is going to become a nuclear waste bin thanks to a revamped AUKUS deal.
There'll be no nuclear transfer from either the US or the UK. That's the detail.
The Albanese government is likely to turn Australia into the 51st state of the United States. We don't need to be basically a pair of shoes hanging out of the American backside.
But the biggest political moment from the last 2 weeks...
I don't have bread.
Oh, I don't have bread.
The PM revealing he doesn't eat bread.
Have you seen what happens to people in this job? You got to have some discipline, you got to have some rules.
Yeah, dropping the bomb to my own cousin. She's someone who has been paying attention to the politics. Please welcome Senator Jacqui Lambie on the desk. All right. If Albo's saying it to my cousin Sean on the radio, you can say it to me to my face. Do you eat bread?
No, I'm still busy with the rainbow popped out of my arse. I'm going to be honest with you. What a great bloke, loving it. Isn't that great?
I feel like he stole your line.
I know, right? He just stole my whole Friday night. That's it, I'm over. Honestly, who beats that?
Oh, my Jacqui, God. The challenge to you is, can you get that into every single press conference that you do for the next fortnight?
I think that I've got Parliament coming up next, so I've got a feeling it might pop up there, that little rainbow.
Yes, I love it, I love it. Look, there was some big news this week, and that namely being the Cabinet reshuffle. But what I'm focusing on is the rumours that we're going to have an election by the end of this year. When do you think that it may be called?
Well, I would have thought if we had another interest rate hike that would put the pressure on them. But I think it doesn't matter what the previous government did for 9 years. Apparently they're not to blame for any of this mess, which really annoys me because it takes everybody in Parliament to take that blame, especially a major party, is that economically people are feeling it. OK, you guys will be feeling it out there as well, and they are feeling it. I mean, a loaf of bread and milk, a 3 litre milk now, you're lucky to get that under $10. So they're going to blame the government of the day. So I just think they're really going to have to watch the numbers. I would have forecasted it for November or towards the end of November. My only problem was it going to be a collision with the one in Queensland? And if the Labor Party does really badly up there, that could come back to them. But I also think if they wait until next May, you're going to have all those school books, you're going to have the big credit cards coming out in February from all your Christmas shopping. Mm. They're actually going into a worse situation in May than what they would be in November this year.
Do you think cost of living is the key?
Cost of living is the key. between your electricity bills and the food that you want to put on your table, it is killing people out there.
That's why the PM's not eating bread.
That's why the PM's not eating bread, mate. Now, he can't afford it.
He's been out. It looks like he's already on the campaign trail because he was at a school. Polly's loved being out of school and trying to win over young voters.
Do you know?
But I don't know.
That's why I'm so different to what they are.
But I don't know if this is the correct way to win over young voters. Have a look.
Hey, do you know what? My puppy can talk.
Oh, terrifying.
Smooth, huh? Smooth operator.
So have you met... that's an app I think everybody had about a good 5 to 10 years ago. But have you met Toto? Can Toto talk?
I have met Toto. He reminds me of a wind-up poodle. That's what he reminds me of. You just need to wind him up. And he took quite a liking to me, actually, Toto.
Really? Do tell.
Yes. Never mind about that bit, but I was at the lodge at the time. I was at the lodge. With a date with the PM and Toto.
Wow.
Yeah,
did Toto talk? Did Toto say, "I love you," or anything like that?
That's what he said, right?
I knew it.
Exactly what he said.
Do you have a pet? Do you bring your pet out onto the campaign trail?
I do.
What do you got? What are you packing?
I'm packing a big bull Arab. And she's packing about an extra 20 kilos.
Wow.
I mean, that's a dog, right? That's a dog.
Is there such
thing? Not a very flattering angle.
Oh, my God.
Doesn't matter what angle you get him on, mate. She's 10 kilos overweight.
I like this show. Is this a political interview?
Yes, this is it.
That's what I do with my bread. I don't waste it. I give it to the dog.
I think that dog needs Ozempic. Anywho, now, Jacqui Lambie, I'm a comedian, so I like to work from home most days. I love my mockies, my laptop. It's a real job. Thank you.
Sounds like a comedian. Yes.
Thank you. I heard that the New South Wales government want people to get out of home, go back into the city to work. What do you think about that? Can you let me stay home, please?
Is that the government workers you're talking about?
Mm-hmm. Yes, the public servants.
Jesus Christ, we'll all be on strike Monday. Beautiful. Great. So, for me, I think it's a great thing because I think inside the cities, I mean, you've only got to look in Melbourne. I travel through that a lot. And since COVID, I just don't believe it's gone back to the way Melbourne used to, especially in the middle of the city there, which is really hurting small business. Yeah. Small business already hurting because of what we're going through. So for me, I would like to see people back in the office, to be honest with you. I'd like to see all the financial people back in there, more time there.
This is not the answer I wanted.
No, you guys wear your pyjamas on stage, Johnny. You don't know the difference. It's all right.
You've seen that, exactly.
You have to get in office as well. I know we're jumping around a lot. Can I ask about the US elections? Because you haven't been on the show, I don't think, since Kamala Harris came in for Joe Biden. What have you made of that? And as a prominent woman in politics, the idea of a female president of the United States?
I don't know what other choice you have. You have to bring your deputy up. So she's certainly... how can I say this politely? She's got a wits about her.
That doesn't sound like a glowing endorsement from you, yeah.
I know, and she can do more than a couple of sentences at once. So that's got to be a bonus.
Yes.
Good on Joe. I would certainly be voting for her.
Okay.
That's for sure.
Okay.
But I wish you the best of luck, and it would be great. I think it's a great thing for America not just to get a woman up, but also a black woman. I think that's wonderful. We've had Obama up there, and I think it would be really good for America. Let her go. There's nothing. Get some woman power up there, girlfriend.
Amen. I'm hearing you.
That's the trouble with the country. You see, I'm not running it.
Yeah.
I mean, women aren't running it.
She's too busy feeding the dog.
Yeah, that's right.
Senator, we really appreciate you taking the time to come in and talk us through all of that. We know that you're very, very busy. Would you please thank Jacqui Lambie?
Thank you.